Hi, let's talk about the mediastinum. In this video, we'll differentiate between the various subdivisions of the mediastinum, both of the four-part schema, so the superior, anterior, middle, and posterior mediastinal spaces, as well as the three-part schema, the prevascular, the visceral, and the paravertebral compartments. Recall that the thoracic cavity has three major spaces. Laterally, we have the pulmonary spaces, which contain the pleurae that encase the lungs, and medially we have the mediastinum, which is encasing the pericardium within the heart as well as the great vessels and other viscera and neurovasculature. That mediastinum can be conceptually divided into either four or three spaces. The classic system is for a four-part schema. The newer system, as of about 2017, that was produced by the International Thymic Malignancy Interest Group, has a three-part schema. But let's look at each of these. So the four-part or classical division of the mediastinum involves a break between the sternal angle. The sternal angle is where the manubrium of the sternum meets the body of the sternum. You can palpate this on yourself. If you feel the midline of your chest, palpate your sternum, you can feel a definite ridge. And if you can imagine an imaginary plane, that's the only way that you get an imaginary plane is to imagine it, that goes posteriorly to the intervertebral disc between T4 and T5. That's going to set a plane. Now, everything above that plane and below the root of the neck, so that's the first rib, is going to be the superior mediastinum. So that's going to be in angle or in association with T2 through T4 vertebrae. Below that is the rest of the mediastinum that sometimes people refer to as the inferior mediastinum, but no one refers to that big space like that. They all call it the individual spaces. So it's important to note that the key to this inferior space is the pericardium, which is outlined here. So everything anterior to the pericardium is the anterior mediastinum. Everything surrounded by the pericardium is the middle mediastinum, and everything posterior to the pericardium is the posterior mediastinum. And this goes back to the bodies of the vertebrae. So we have an anterior, a middle, and a posterior space, and the floor of these spaces is that convex surface of the diaphragm. So as we can see, The spaces are unequal in height. So the shallowest space is the middle mediastinum. The next most is the anterior. And the posterior mediastinum dips way down to the 12th thoracic vertebrae. So that goes fairly far. We can contrast this with a three-part scheme. This was developed by the International Thymic Malignancy Interest Group, or ITMIG, in 2017. They set out to construct a schema for the mediastinum that was based off of solid multi-detector CT technology with designated landmarks. And so these are ways in which they can, with specific landmarks, discuss the locations of various mediastinal malignancies or masses. And this is a three-compartment system. It's fairly straightforward. The superior boundary is still rib one. The inferior boundary is still the diaphragm, but how they divide up that space varies. So the first compartment is the prevascular compartment, and what the boundary is the anterior aspect of the pericardium, and then you continue that all the way up to the first rib. So everything anterior to that is the prevascular compartment. So that might contain the thymus gland. Everything behind that all the way back to a boundary that is 1 centimeter posterior to the anterior edge of the vertebral body. So if you can imagine the vertebral bodies stacked upon one another as part of the bony spine here, 1 centimeter back from the anterior edge of the vertebral body would look something like this. So that is the posterior border of this compartment, and it's called the visceral compartment. The visceral compartment is going to contain, you know, the heart within the mediastinum, or within the pericardium. It's going to contain the bronchi, the great vessels, etc. And now a major departure from the above classification is this paravertebral compartment. In the four-part mediastinum, the anterior edge of the vertebrae was really the end or the limit of the mediastinum. But in this system, they take advantage of the space that is adjacent to the lateral bodies of the, or the lateral surfaces of the vertebral bodies. So all of this space becomes the paravertebral compartment. So we have a prevascular anterior to the pericardium. We have a visceral, which goes from that anterior border all the way back to 1 centimeter behind the leading edge of the vertebral bodies. And then we have a paravertebral compartment that is to the side of the bodies of the vertebrae. So we've discussed the two mediastinal schema, the classic four-part system, the newer three-compartment system. This is your summary slide, and thank you for your time.